Okay, students, let us discuss about IDFT algorithms today. We have already covered up DFT algorithms using fast Fourier transformation, that also with DITFFT and DIFFFT. With the same concept, we will continue to find IDFT. Okay? First, let me take the formula for IDFT. I will write IDFT formula. You know that in IDFT, you will be finding out x of n, you are given with x of k. I am finding x of n here. I will write the formula for x of n. X of n is equal to 1 over n summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k wn raised to minus k. This is the fundamental formula for IDFT. You see, you are given with x of k. This becomes input. X of k is input. This is the first thing. And x of n or time domain signal is output. It is output. Okay. This is very important. X of k or frequency domain signal is input and time domain signal or x of n is output. This is first thing. Next, the Tweedle factor. Tweedle factor in the formula is conjugate because of that minus. That means in case of our original DFT formula, it was wn raised to kn. Here it is wn raised to minus kn. Hence, it is the conjugate. Conjugate in the sense, suppose w41 is equal to minus j. Now you are using w4 minus 1. The meaning here is the minus j becomes the conjugate, that is plus j. That's what is the meaning of Tweedle becomes conjugate in the formula. This is the second point. And the third important point is there is 1 by n multiplying factor. Multiplying factor. Here in the formula, there is 1 by n multiplying factor is there. Right? This is the third point which you should remember. That I hope you understood the formula as a concept. First thing is x of k is input and x of n is output. This is the first point. Second is the Tweedle factor becomes the conjugate. The third point is the multiplying factor is there in the formula, that is 1 by n. Okay, that's what is the conceptual understanding of IDFT formula, and we will be applying it. You are already aware of how exactly to apply 4-point DFT. Let me take an example here. I will just take an example with respect to this formula above and solve. Okay, example, I'm just taking it here. Example, I'm just taking it here in the IDFT formula. I have given with x of k, it is given as 4 minus j2 0 and plus j2. Now this is the given x of k. Find x of n using decimation in time, DITFFT radix 2 algorithm. Okay, I am taking a simple n is equal to 4 here. N is equal to 4. Let me take n is equal to 4, and obviously I will just solve this example. I will just both examples I will solve here. First I will use with DITFFT. Okay, DITFFT to find inversion, that is IDFT. I will just draw four straight lines here. Very simple. It's a fun actually doing this fast Fourier transformation algorithms. Yeah, four lines I have drawn here. Okay, now see, very importantly, decimation in time, but although it says decimation in time, please decimate it always, whether it is IDFT or DFT, at input side. Please make decimation in input side. The output in DIT becomes serial. That is correct. You know that while you are finding DFT, input was decimated, correct? But here also, while you find IDFT also, you have to decimate the input. Hence, big X I'm writing. First X naught, then X2, then X1, and then X3. I'm decimating here. Input is decimated. Okay, input is decimated, right? I wrote that. Now X naught is equal to 4. 4. X2 is equal to 0. X1 is equal to minus J2. And X3 is equal to plus J2. Correct? It is plus J2. Now, you know that in our DITFFT algorithm, crisscross comes in the first starting stage, isn't it? I just draw here points so that, right, here minus 1 is there, here minus 1 is there. After this, I just have another long crisscross at the output, correct? Right, here it is minus 1. Now, very importantly, here W4 minus 0, W4 minus 1. Okay, this is one thing, right? And this is the first point. That means you are writing the frequency signal, frequency signal at the input. As I have written, told here, input is frequency and you are decimating it. And then you are writing the Tweedle factor W4 minus 0, W4 minus 1. Okay. And here it is, I will write W4 minus 0 is 1 anyway. W4 minus 1 is minus J is W4 1. It is plus J. Correct? Plus J. And finally here, after you get the answer, you should multiply with 1 by n. That is the third point which I told here. That means 4 point DFT, you are supposed to multiply by 1 by 4. These are very important things which you are making in case of IDFT algorithms. Okay. Now, very simple to do. I have drawn already all the flow diagram. Now, simple thing is to add and subtract and multiply with Tweedle factor. That is the only thing which you have to do. Now, I will come here. 4 and 0 added. Written 4. 4 minus 0. 4 minus 0, 4. Then coming to here. Minus J2 and plus J2 added. 0. Minus J2 minus J2. Total is minus J4. Now, these 4 and 4 transferred further. 4 and 4 are transferred further. Next, W40 is 1 multiplied by 0 anyway, it is 0. Minus J4 multiplied by J. Minus J square 4. Minus J square 4 means what? Minus J square is 1, hence it is 4. Now, I am into this stage now. 4 and 0 comes here, adding gives you 4. 4 and 4 adding gives you 8. Then 4 minus 0, 4. 4 minus 4, 0. Now, my answer get multiplied by the factor of 1 by n. 4 into 1 by 4 is equal to 1. 8 into 1 by 4, that means 8 divided by 4, it is 2. Now 4 divided by 4, 1. 0 divided by 4 is 0. Now, what about the output? Output is x of n. Output is x of n. It comes in serial. X0, x1, x2, and x3. I got output written here. Hence, my answer I will write here. Answer I will write in a consolidated manner. Anyway, you can write like this also. Because it is x of n, no complex terms are there here as such. 1, 2, 1, 0. That's what is my answer. Okay. I got answer with DITFFT algorithm. Okay. Same way in this session itself. Now I continue here so that DIFFT I will use to find. Okay. DIFFT algorithm for IDFT. IDFT. I will just go again to draw four straight lines here. Four straight lines. Okay. Now, no difference between both algorithm as such. Now the long twiddle, whatever is there, that comes in the input side, correct? Long twiddle, whatever is there, that comes in the input side, and crisscross twiddle, crisscross butterfly goes to the output side. That's all. That's what is all about DIF, correct? The long crisscross comes in the starting. Right. Now, here, the crisscross. Here it is -1, -1, and then here W4 -0, W4 -1. Okay. Now, while you write here, what about this? It is serial. Input side it is serial. DIF output is decimated. Output is decimated. Now I have to write it in serial. Hence, I will just transfer this data here. 4 -J2, 0 and +J2. I am not writing X0, X1, whatever, because it is straight transferring of data from given data into the flow diagram, isn't it? That's why I am not bothered writing X0, X2, etc. Because here I am writing, it is important that I should transfer a proper data. Here I am not doing it. Now, coming to this, 4 + 0, 4, then J2 - J2 added, 0. Okay. Now this comes here, 4 - 0, 4 - 0, 4. Now -J2 - J2 - J4. Now 4 and 0 transferred further. 4 multiplied by twiddle factor. If you want, you write W4 - 0 is 1 and W4 - 1 is +J. Now 4 into 1, that is 4, -J4 into +J - J²4. Now last here -1 - 1, and after this 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Please don't forget about this multiplying factor. Generally students will forget about this multiplying factor and they go wrong here. Now 4 + 0, 4, 4 - 0, 4, 4 + 4, 8, 4 - 4, 0. Now after this 4 divided by 4, 4 divided by 4, then 8 divided by 4, and 0. Now here it is decimated. Please see that output is decimated. This is X0, this is X2, this is X1, this is X3. Hence my answer is, if you want, again write in this manner, X0 is equal to 1, X1 is equal to 2, X2 is equal to 1 and X3 is equal to 0. That's what is my answer. If you want to write in this format also, you write it 1 2 1 0. I got answers. This simple, n is equal to 4, DITFFT as well as DIFFFT to find IDFT, inverse discrete Fourier transformation, I have done. I hope you remember this algorithm very easily from the given formula. Input given is frequency signal or X of K, big X. Output to be found is X of N or small x. Importantly, twiddle factor get conjugate as well as there will be a multiplying factor. If you can keep this in mind, otherwise there is no change at all. In DITFFT, you are decimating at the input side. Don't bother that you are decimating time or anything. You are decimating at input side, both in DIT as well as IDFT. While you are doing this, apply the same concept. Okay, I hope you got this. If you want to apply this for n is equal to 8, also it is possible. You can do that. Anyway, I will solve one example in case of 8 point DFT in the next IDFT in the next class. Anyway, but this is very important. 4 point while you are finding IDFT, no, that is very important because next example whatever we are going to solve applies Stackhoms method. Okay, Stackhoms method it applies. Hence, it is important for us to know n is equal to 4 to find IDFT. Thank you. I will post the assignment on this. You can solve that and send me. Okay, I'm very happy that you are moving along with the assignments. Okay, let us continue this. Thank you.